Thank you. Group singers, and we certainly appreciate the majestic hymn that you sang, and as we expect for the Lord's any moment coming, that it is with a blessed hope, and we are grateful that you have sung a song that is truly God-glorifying, God-glorifying, Christian-edifying, and to those that are without Christ, that it's a solemn reminder that if they don't meet Christ this side of heaven, they are hopeless, helpless, and hell-bound, because it is said that hell is at the end of a Christless life. May God bless us, and let me give you some important announcements in view of the fact that soon, April 11, we will have our 47th church anniversary, and Sunday before that, I believe that it would be God-honoring na tayo ay first Sunday ng April, we would meet the Lord in the Lord's table. But we have to all follow restrictions and observe the protocols. Kaya ito ang narapat na alamin natin. First, only between 90 to 100 na members who are, of course, members in good spiritual standing. Second, priority list ito ay those that are regularly every Sunday that are here. Third, ay yung mga at least within this month ay nakapunta itong month of March dito. Okay? And then kung may lugar pa, knowing that you are really desirous and in good spiritual condition as a church member, you may still fill the gap sa minimum, and then maximum. We cannot go beyond that because we want to observe distancing, okay? And they call it social distancing, but we are social beings, so it's a gathering. We have to sit, okay? Only on the pews that is marked for sitting by those in attendance. Okay? And other than that, pagpasok mo pa lang ay marami ng procedures na gagawin tayo. And kung kayo ay inuubo, tulad na sabi ko dati, okay, bawal ang umubo dito. Pwede, ayan, okay? Okay, and then, kayo ay may nararamdaman, by all means, stay home. Don't put the rest in peril, okay? Ang iba ay maapektuhan pa, okay? So, stay home, and then self-quarantine, okay? As you rest, okay? And I hope and pray that, of course, this is exclusively for church members, okay? Lalagyan pa natin redundant, only. Kasi may mga nag-insist tulad nung sa labas ay medyo nakipagtalo na hindi naman member gusto mag-attend. Much as gusto natin, yet we do not know kung sila ay flag carrier. Sila ay carrier na dahil doon, hindi naman natin kilala, ay makahawa pa. Okay? So I hope and pray that we would observe protocols as well as, okay, inform the church secretary, okay, that you will be coming and first Sunday yon, and I hope na pakinggan maigi ng ating secretary na ito ang dapat susundin natin, okay? Then come April 11, we'll have a whole day service, and then the afternoon service will commence at 4:30, and hopefully before the sun sets, we will be at home, because by that time ay summer na. As a matter of fact, this month is supposed to be summer month, at medyo ang araw ay mataas pa at gabi na. Okay? So sa Lord's Supper natin, we'll still meet at 4:30, but we will eat and drink, okay, exactly at 6 o'clock in the evening. May araw pa yun, ginagarantiya ko, sapagkat tiningi ko sa Panginoon, napigilan niya muna ang araw na lumubog. Just like the time of Joshua and the time of King Hezekiah. Naalala niyo yun? Okay. And may the Lord be glorified in these gatherings. And thank you very much for braving the threat of the supposed ongoing COVID-19 of variants pa na iba-ibang mga tinaguriyan. Ang hindi ko marinig ay Filipino variant. Dapat localize yun. Wala eh. African, British, whatever, what have you. Pero Filipina, wala pa. Talagang. Okay, so, may the Lord cover us up under His omnipotence, and inside out, He would keep us safe until such time the Lord makes that call for us, come up. Okay, so without any I guess I have not overlooked any announcement, so now we will proceed. Okay, we will proceed with and I hope I can conclude the message on the rapture this morning. Would you please flash on the screen chart ng rapture. There are some things that I suppose you have never heard from others, that as I studied and checked my Bible, I stand firmly on this. If you disagree with my position, you are entitled to that. Okay? We have so liberty. But when we see that the Bible clearly and authoritatively teaches it, then we are all bound to submit to the voice of God and for His glory as well as for our good. So 1 Corinthians chapter 15, I gave us already the outline that we are following in our study on the teaching of the Bible on such a comforting promise that Jesus said, I will come again. I hope na hindi tayo naiinip at tayo ay umaasa na anumang sandali ang Panginoon, because looking at the Bible, we are at the brink or at the end of the church period or age. Nasa dulong-dulo na tayo. And the only thing that keeps us and separates this present economy or dispensation or age is actually the rapture, and that after ay hell on earth. Okay? A period of 7 years which Daniel prophesied and which will rule, the Antichrist will rule, okay, globally, and we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together to meet the Lord in the air. But next Lord's Day, before tribulation period commences, Revelation chapter 6, at doon na tayo pupunta, makikita ninyo, time is fast running out for those in the present age of grace. And what is happening today are preparatory for that event that never happened in the world before. And it's the worst of times, as our Lord Jesus Christ described it. It's really a great loss. If you are a church member and you have not had been born again, nor had a relationship with Jesus Christ, you will be left behind. Okay? Endure that, because you cannot enjoy it. Okay? And God helping us, may members of Calvary Baptist Church here in Quezon City would be majority converted. Okay? As we commence and close on the subject of the rapture of the saints, this is very, very specific. The rapture of the saints. Some think that a saint is someone that is beatified and canonized by a church. Now, in view of your good works and participation in activities of the said church, you will be honored to become a saint. And some others mistake what a saint is, that it is someone who is saved by works or by church membership, which again, the Bible does not teach. So, what is a saint? A saint is a sinner saved by the grace of God. He is blood bought. He is covered by the blood of Jesus Christ, whose sin cleanses us from all sins and stains of life, and who assures us of a home in heaven. Okay? That is what a saint is. But the question must be asked, are you a saint? Kaya ba ay santo, mga binanal ng Diyos? Are you a saint? The word saint is also hagios, is the word hagios, or separated ones, or it means sanctified or set apart to God, from idols to serve the living God. Okay? So kayo ay naligtas sa biyaya ng Diyos. At ang mabubuting gawa ay bunga ito ng isang anak ng Diyos, sapagkat siya lamang ang kinaruroonan at kinakasiyahan ng Espiritu ng Diyos. So, yung mga unsaved may be able to perform good works in the sight of men, But these are sa harap ng Diyos ay pawang mga maruruming basahan. Okay? So, it's of no value to God because the only good works that God expects are good works that are fruits of the Spirit, that is a fruition or consequence of the Spirit's presence and doing sa ating mga buhay. Okay, so buksan natin ang ating mga banal na kasulatan. So first, kaya I suppose you are a saint this morning. Otherwise, this message on the rapture of the saints doesn't mean a thing to you if you are not in Christ. Because the issue dito sa rapture ay those that have died in Christ, those that sleep in Christ, and we which are still alive or living but are in Christ, yung phrase na in Christ ang nagbibigay ng halaga o timbang doon, ng weight doon sa mga taong aagawin ng Panginoon when that day comes. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, ating basahin dito sa verse 51. Okay, we have already read this as well as hanggang verse 53, and in comparison with 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 13 to 18, because the same writer expounded and explained this coming or future, okay, meeting in the air by the Lord and for His saints. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. Father, bless your word, and as we hopefully close our study on such teaching of the Bible, of which every child of God is still alive and expecting to come in our lifetime. Thank you for being our prayer answering God. We are out of words to express how much we appreciate you, adore you, and thank you from the language of our hearts for your place in our hearts as the triune God, and for your great works for us. Bless us, we continue and close our study, hopefully, on this truth that the Bible teaches us of and about. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. The rapture of the saints. There are five passages tungkol sa rapture in the New Testament. If you recall or remember, there were three things that I mentioned which are derived na ito ay hango dito sa setas ng 1 Corinthians at kasama ang 1 Thessalonians. First, the Apostle Paul mentioned that the rapture is a mystery. Okay, it was formerly hidden sa Old Testament, and then sa New Testament, it was not known until the Apostle Paul wrote on the subject. There are two things that we can discover dito sa kanyang isinulat na passages tungkol sa mystery of the rapture. Ang mystery ng rapture na ito ay isinulat niya with authority and with accuracy that this mystery of the rapture, how that death is not a mystery, the rapture is. And two things ang kanyang isinishare dito sa passages na ito before I continue the message. The first thing that he mentioned, futuristic ito, it's from their time until such time, whenever the Lord comes, it is imminent or any moment. The first thing that he would want us to understand and be impressed sa ating mga puso na ito ay nasa ating mga isipan at puso is that the mystery of the rapture, which is no longer a mystery because it is now revealed through the pens of the Apostle Paul, the rapture is an event, a very special event. It's an event. Okay? Second, the rapture is an experience. But nasabi ko ito, other than it is a teaching of the Bible irrespective of the timing that you believe, whether it's pre-tribulation as I do, or mid-tribulation, or post-tribulation, it is, okay, an event. Okay? And also, the rapture is an experience. Mararanasan ito. The proof of this ay pinatutunayan sa atin in both testaments. So Old Testament, we are given a preview of this event as well as its experience in the person of two Old Testament believers by the name of Enoch and Elijah. So, assume na alam ninyo ito. They were caught up to heaven, okay, alive. Okay? And we are not informed what succeeding process ginawa ng Panginoon sa kanila, but we are assured that God caught them up to heaven. And those that objects dito sa dalawang ito, anya, they were not allowed to enter heaven because ang argument nila ay sabi nila, flesh and blood shall not enter into the kingdom of heaven. That is a correct verse. But my friend, God is not limited. He could do something for them so that they could come before His presence in heaven. Huwag niyong limitan ng Diyos. The second argument nila that flesh and blood, kinakailangan either you die o kaya you would be raptured, matranslate ka, mabago ka, is the second argument that they pose. Ayang sabi nila, yung heaven na kinaroroon na nila ay second heaven lamang in either of the planets. Sabi ko, ang earth lang ang may tao, isang katauhan. Okay? So anyway, yun ang argument nila. If, ito ang rebuttal ko, if, sa mga position kasi ng post eh, if, assuming you are right na they are merely living in any of these planets in heaven, not in the third heaven, in the presence of God, okay, sabi ko, ang dalawang Old Testament saints na ito with their body and still blood in their bodies, kung totoo ang sinasabi ninyo, they would have died. Bakit? More than 2,000 years na. They cannot live that long. Yan ang kinakuhan ko. But even then, it's for the sake of argument. Okay? And be courteous. Naintindihan ba ninyo? Okay? So, it's a guessing game. Sa akin, it's no guessing game. Pag sinabi ng Panginoon, bahala ang Panginoon na sila ay paintulutan na makarating sapagkat hindi naman nila kalooban o kagustuhan, kundi kalooban ng Diyos. That is how sovereign my God is. The second is an event that other than these two Old Testament believers that were caught up to heaven alive, and the New Testament teaches that Enoch was translated into heaven. Elijah was fetched by a chariot of fire. In the New Testament, to add to this event and experience, we find two men na nakaranas, sabi ng iba, well, yeah, that's astral travel. I don't believe that. I believe that God really caught them up. And this is, of course, two writings and writers of the Bible ang nagpapatotoo dito. Una, si Apostle Paul sa 2 Corinthians chapter 12, he was caught up and he used the phrase caught up about two or three times. And in 2 Corinthians chapter 12, from verse 1 to 3. Hindi niya nang makilala kanyang sarili. He was really overjoyed and so amazed that the beauties and the glories of heaven was beyond human description, sabi niya doon. And then, second, si John the Beloved, nang sabi ng Panginoon para maisulat niya lahat ang calls of future, come up hither. So this man. So these four men, we find two men were raptured alive and two men, after having experienced it, died during their lifetime on earth. One was Martin, the Apostle Paul, and John the Beloved died of natural cause because of old age. Okay, so ang liwanag, di ba? Ang liwanag ng Biblia, but I just can't believe it kung bakit hindi nila makita ang maliwanag ng aral ng Biblia. So now, we will come to the second of the three points. The first is the rapture is a mystery, which is now revealed for more than 2,000 years since the time of the Apostle Paul. Exclusive siya nito. And as a matter of fact, another mystery was shown to him, and that is the mystery how that the church that Jesus Christ established is made up not only of the Jews, but also Gentiles saved and baptized. Okay? So he said that the middle wall of partition is removed. They can be one body before the Lord. That is in that local church that Jesus Christ established during his public ministry. And sa future, pagdating natin sa Revelation, another mystery na nababanggit rin ito ng ibang writers, but bukod tanging si Apostle Paul ang nagbanggit nito, na ito ay it will take place after the rapture, ay sa kanin natin kunin. Okay? Sa Revelation chapter 6 na, the third mystery na sa kanya lamang ibinigay ng kaliwanagan na naisulat niya ito. Okay? So it's no longer a mystery because we are now very much informed about these future events from where we are. Second, the moment of the rapture. Dito nagkakatalo ang mga naniniwala sa rapture. Some hold to the position ng pre-tribulation. Pag sinabing pre, before. And this is how I see my Bible. And this is where I stand. and here I die, so help me God. Okay? Prayer tribulation. When the 7 years, futuristic it are, when the 7 years begins after disposition, may mga niniwala sa mid-tribulation na mga teaching na ito ngayon ay they are also described as itong mid-tribulation sa gitna ay partial rapture, na ang makakaranas at makakasama lang sa rapture sa gitna ay yung mga faithful Christians. So in other words, papasok ang mga Kristiyano. Lahat ng Kristiyano mula sa panahon ng Panginoon in Christ ay papasok dyan. Maiwanan sa mid-tribulation na tinatawag rin nila ito ngayon, very tricky. Mid-tribulation, partial rapture. In Bible College, I have had a classmate na he holds to this position. Okay? Lahat ng ibinigay niya na talata has no bearing on such teaching niya on partial or mid-tribulation. A new word is coined for this, of which kung hindi nakuha ng dalawang previous mid and partial rapture chure ay itong tinatawag na pre-wrath. Okay? Pre-wrath coming ng Panginoon. That's still mid-trib. Kaya nga anya, pre-wrath dito sa gitna. Okay. So, which also I beg to disagree. Okay? Third, ito'y malaki ito. As a matter of fact, maraming nahatak nito. Itong post-tribulation na lahat ng mga mananampalataya sa buong kapanahunan ay isahan na sila ay sasalubungin ng Panginoon at kukunin sa rapture pagkatapos ng pag-akyat nila halfway ay kasama sila ng Panginoon dito sa lupa. We will check that out in the book of Revelation and from the other books of the New Testament, we will find that is quite absurd and not acceptable to the position like we do, okay? Na pinaparatangan nila ang pre-trib, iba-ibang tawag nila dito na maling-mali, okay? Na ito raw ay invention lamang ng tao. There was no pre-tribulation rapture teaching before John Darby, Edward Irving, itong si a young teenager by the name, Scottish young lady by the name of Margaret MacDonald, and itong si Father Lacunza, etc. That is before 1830. We can find in history from the Bible and prior to 1830 that they already teach the two stages and the pre-tribulation position is the one that is in antiquity. Okay? Bago lamang itong post-tribulation na pinapopularize ni Alexander Rees and isang Baptist rin na nagsulat ng Blessed Hope na ito ang kanyang position, ang kanyang pangalan ay si Baptist preacher na ito, which is not very popular, si George Ladd, if I can recall, si Ladd, okay? So, L-A-D-D ang kanyang apelyido, okay? Sila ay allergic, ang mga positive allergic sa position ng pre-trib sapagkat anya ay pinasikat lamang ng Scofield Reference Bible yung pre-trib. Okay? In other words, prior to that, meron na. Okay? So, Ngayon ay sa moment of the rapture. Ilang minutes pa ba? The moment of the rapture. We find here timing of the rapture. Although the word in a moment refers more than the time that we believe that the rapture will take place, the word moment actually emphasizes talagang this is something that is with force, na talagang ito ay the snatching up, the lifting up of believers is engaged with force. Okay? Ang salitang in a moment ay it refers more or less to this more than time. Ang salitang moment dito, if you check it out, refers to the Greek word atomos. Atomos. Atomos, which is translated in English as atom. Ang best description nito ay ang atomos is actually an energy which is so small. This, nung panahon, ang atom is considered as the smallest kasi hindi pa advanced ang science. So, ang word na atom, the smallest energy which cannot be divided or ito ay indivisible anya, it is such a power that is either, okay, destructive or constructive. Although today, ang smallest ay kahit ang atom sa may pag-aaral ko, ay ang atom na then considered in all time as the smallest particle or element of energy, indivisible, can now be divided, na ito ay magiging mas higit na maliit pa, na ito ay sa pamagitan ng neutron. And then further, reducing it, ay ang word na ipinangalan sa sasakyan na gawa sa Malaysia, proton. Okay, so we just have to stick the word atomos. Is powerful. It's an energy that is both destructive or constructive. It is with force and power. During World War, Axis country, Germany and Japan, they tried to rule the world. Okay, Europe ang sa Germany at Asia ang sa Japan. And the Japanese even landed on our shore, and many countries in Asia nasasakop ng mga Japanese. And na-involved na ang America, which they can no longer take it, ay America entered into the war. And to put a stop to Second World War, para higit na mabawasan ang casualties ng war, both in human lives as well as in properties, ay America unleashed two atomic bombs. Atomic, don't say atom. Atomic bomb. Inulugan a less populated areas ng Japan to wake them up and to put a stop to World War II. Inulugan ng Amerika ng atom bomb, atomic bomb, ang Hiroshima. And the second ay ang Nagasaki. You know his duration, nakakaalam na nito. Okay, yung duration hindi pa alam. And nung inulugan nila ito, maniwala ko hindi, marami ring mga tao ang namatay. At even the hardest steel, yung mga buildings at mga steels ay nangatunaw. Wow, very powerful. Kaya nga lang kung magsusunod pang war ay mas nakakatakot because neutron bombs are available. Grabe, powers. But I guess sa Armageddon ito, yung papakawala. But just the event will not be around. It's not of concern to us. Okay? Because whether life or death, we are blessed in that we have a home in heaven. Although, ako gusto ko rapture because I have conducted funeral services that I can no longer remember kung sa dami, kung ilan ito. From newly born to old age and sick and what have you. Nakalulungkot, okay? But it seems to me that it's an appointment with God. So, dito ay mapapansin natin nang sabi ni Apostle Paul, in a moment, with all the force, the energy of heaven, ay the Lord, when He comes, He will lift up, He will snatch, He will caught up, sabi ni Apostle Paul, all believers from the time of the cross, from the time of Jesus, to the time of the closing of the New Testament church. Yun ang mga involved. Sapagkat ginamit niya dito in both these passages sa Corinthians and sa Thessalonians, ginamit niya ang specific na mga taong kabahagi dito na ito ay those that are in Christ, those that died or slept in Christ. Yung ibig sabihin ng in Christ ay talagang sila ay kinaroroonan ng Espiritu ng Diyos na nagbibigay kasiguruhan na ang gawain ng Panginoong Kristo sa cross ay ipinagkaloob at meron na silang kasiguruhan. They have eternal life. Naintindihan niyo ba yung phrase na in Christ? So those that are dead in Christ and those that are still alive during this end times, the closing days of the New Testament church, they will together meet the Lord in the air. Okay? He will meet the Lord in the air. And next week, kung matapos ko ito, we will continue kung bakit the Lord will meet us in the air before He takes us to the third heaven, a prepared place for prepared people where God resides. Because in the second heavens where the Lord will meet us, very popular ito na kung tribulation judgments dito doon sa langit before entering the residence of God ay ang katotohanan na magkakaroon ng katapatan at katotohanan ang pamagat ng mensahe ko in advance this Sunday, payday someday. Payday someday. Totoo sa lupa at totoo doon sa second heavens. Payday someday. And I'll explain it what is meant by that. Okay, so ngayon, sabi dito ni Apostle Paul, in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, yung salitang atomos, talagang full of energy and power. And none can stop what God will do in meeting His people in the air. The second word, in the twinkling of an eye, it used to be sa science, ang kisap mata. Yung tawag dito, kalama ba yun? Twinkling of an eye. Kisap mata. Sa movie world, sa Hollywood din, yung reel nila na ginagawa nila para may salarawan ang isang pangyayari na ginagampanan ng mga artista ay ito. Sabi nila, twinkling of an eye, ang description nila is 1/20 of a second. Sunod-sunod yan. Yung film strips para maipicture lamang ang isang event. However, in the twinkling of an eye dito, ang dinidescribe, palibas ay advanced ang science ngayon, itong tinutukoy ni Apostle Paul goes far beyond the Hollywood description of this reel of film na sa isang second 24 pictures ang lumalabas expressing the same thing ay itong salita niyang itong in a twinkling of an isang kisap mata ay it is 1/10 so swift and so fast, 1/10 kalahati, kinati yan, 1/10 of a second. So 1/10 of a second ng kisap mata mo ay makikita mo rin yung nasa harap mo, yung lawak ng nasa harap mo. Okay, so ating mapapansin, that is how swift itong, how fast itong rapture na ito. And the last trump, yung salitang trump na ito, yung marching order ng Panginoon, tulad ng Roman legion at mga soldiers, dapat nag-iingay sila at pagkaharap na nila yung kanilang mga kaaway, the soldiers with their shields, they would beat to make a sound, they would beat their shield as they move forward, and that is para maunahan ng takot yung mga kalaban. Kung nakapanood kayo ng Roman soldiers ng movie of film na ginagawa nila ito, okay, in ancient time. And then the trumpet, yung message na pinapaabot sa different classes of soldiers, whether infantry or horseback, na ito ay meron silang bugler. Mag-sound the trumpet, this is now for the horsemen to attack. So ganun yun, trumpet. And also, the trumpet is not ushering a marching order, but it also implies a judgment that will follow. Kaya nga, it's going to be a payday someday, both after the rapture and during the tribulation period. You can't escape. Before the Lord takes us to our mansions or homes in heaven, we will go through this process, etc. So, ating akala ko ba no more condemnation? Sure, no more condemnation. But the Bible does not guarantee that no more judgment sa mga believers. Meron. Okay. Meron judgment ang believers. But it is not as frightening as the judgments that will be poured out or unleashed dito sa lupa. Okay, kaya nga, payday someday. Okay? At the rapture is going to be payday someday. Sa't ba kunaroon? At the last trump, the sound of the trumpet. Now, here's the point before I proceed. Sa third point, ay ating mapapansin ang sabi dito, as the trumpet is sounded, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible. Yung mga katawang lupa na nangabulok na, that has been in the graves for thousands of years from the days of our Lord to the day that He comes to rapture, they will all be raised. At yung mga kaluluwa ng mga kapatirang ito na nauna, ay sasalubungin at bubuhayin muli ito. But iba ng katawan, the same identity, but glorified bodies na. Ito'y tinatawag na resurrected bodies, just like the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, without sin, without weakness, or without any scar of whatever may have happened to your body during your lifetime on earth. So, dito ay unahin silang babangon kasi sila ang nakahiga. Unahin silang babangunin. Then, we which are alive, okay? Sabi dito ni Apostle Paul sa 1 Thessalonians, and remain, okay? Alive, shall be caught up together. Hindi una-unahan, together. Nakita mo na yung mahal mo sa buhay na ligtas, binuhay na maguli ng Panginoon, kasi hindi mo naman kinakailangan. Ang resurrection ay binabangon. By all means, hindi inyo binabangon ang isang taong gising at nakatayo. Maliban na lang may sleep disorder siya. Naalala ko tuloy, speaking of that, sa isang church ay may isang member na mag-asawa at tuwing nagpe-preach ang faithful sila sa church attendance, yung pastor, para siya, he felt insulted na yung asawang lalaki ng isang church member, both of them are, ay tumatayo at naglalakad. Okay. Parang yung pastor ay nabahala siya. He could no longer take it. After the service, nilapitan niya. Sabi niya, sister, nadidistract tuloy ako. Bakit naman ang mister mo, tuwing nagpe-preach ako, siya ay tumatayo at naglalakad? Nadidistract ako. And some two are. Sabi ng missus, ay pastor, yan po ang sakit ng aking mister. Okay? He is at home. He is walking in his sleep. Kaya dala niya pa dito sa church. Please don't walk in your sleep. Sleepwalking in church. Okay, so, naalala ko yun. So, dito ay ating mapapansin, sabay-sabay na sila ay they will meet the Lord in the air. Okay, makikita natin. And someone said, isang drunkard, by the name of Trotter. Ay siya ay drunkard. Walang saysay ang kanya. He was wasting his life. Uminom at pagkatapos na humihingi ng limos para siya ay maka-inom. On one occasion, si Trotter ay na-witnessan at binigyan ng gospel tract na bago siya malasing, nabasa niya ito. And then suddenly, Trotter the drunkard was converted and he did not remain a drunkard. Ngayon, he is known in the community as Trotter the Evangelist. Siya ay isang evangelista. Siya ay nangangaral na ngayon ng gospel. Trotter the Evangelist. And he said this, sabi ni Trotter, the evangelist, a new life in Christ na meron siya. Sabi niya, a Christian never say goodbye for the last time. Ang isang Kristiyano ay hindi namamaalam for the last time. Goodbye ba? Tama yan. Bye-bye. The last goodbye. Bakit? Eh, magkikita naman eh. At the time of the rapture, your loved ones that went home to be with the Lord before the rapture, makikitang muli ninyo ito. So, there'll be no goodbye. So I like what he said. Christians never say the last goodbye because we will see and meet each other again and never to be separated. Okay? Saan ba ako naroon? The motivation. Before I proceed with this, na naintindihan na ninyo, those that died in Christ and those that are alive in Christ lamang ang exclusively will meet the Lord Jesus Christ in the air. But let me pause to add to this, because this is a question that has been asked over and over again, and parents are actually, Christian parents are actually asking this, a question which is very hard to answer. Okay? However, checking the scriptures, we can find that the Lord Jesus Christ and our God, He does something about the answer to Christian parents who may have lost a loved one, either in infancy or before reaching the age of accountability, either 4 or 5, na wala pa silang knowledge of good and evil, and their nature is not fully bloomed so that they can engage in sins. And the answer to this, we are saved by grace. When Christians na may dinadala sa kanilang sinapupunan, tulad ni Jean, tulad ng makapatirang Kristiyano na may dinadala, buntis, okay? At may mga anak na sanggol, mag-asawa ay ligtas. Sa rapture, sigurado sila. But how about the babies in infancy doon sa loob ng sinapupunan at mga babies na ito, that they are still so and too dependent upon their parents? What will happen to them? The answer of this, kung salvation is wholly and solely by the grace of God, the answer to this is, when God takes care of that, it's known as, to me, it's known as the 5 points of prevenient grace. Prevenient grace. Binabaluktot ito. Kung merong 5 points of sovereign grace, alam ninyo yon. Do you believe that? Alam ba ninyo yung tulip? Meron ring, ako itemize ko rin, yung 5 points of landmarkism. Sinulat ko rin ito, etc. Ngayon, ito namang sa grace, kung paano nagliligtas ang Panginoon, lalo na sa mga sanggol na namatay at mga anak na mga Kristiyanong namatay before reaching the age of accountability. Only God knows kung kailan ito, but somehow it manifests doon sa buhay ng mga bata. To me, parang the way I size it is between infancy at doon sa age na 5 or 6, kasi wala pang kamuang kaya tinatanggap sila ngayon sa elementary, at age 7, kasi yun ang number sa Bible rin sa atin. Every 7, there are 8 days in a week, right? Nakalimutan nyo, 7 lang. Kaya always 7 sa Bible. On the 7th day, it speaks of perfection or completion. Now, this is a comfort to those that are pregnant among the saints, as well as yung mga anak nila na nag-alala. Sabi ng isang dating deacon, sabi niya, kung alam ko na bukas mag-rapture na, ay pipilipitin ko ng lig ng aking sanggol na anak. You don't have to do that because you will be guilty of murder, infanticide. But God has taken care of that. Ang tawag dito, prevenient grace. What is prevenient grace? The 5 points of prevenient grace. Kasama yan ng magulang. Kung kayo nagdadala, tawag kayo mabahala, hindi kayo makakaranas ng miscarriage. o abortion, kasama yan, automatic yun, ay sila ay maging separate person, okay, in God's plan. Prevenient grace. Ang 5 points of prevenient grace is number one, the love of God. The love of God woos us sa adults and ganun rin sa children na hindi nila alam ito. Second, sa prevenient grace, not only is the love of God wooing them, kundi sa prevenient grace ay the will of God is drawing them. My Father will draw them to me. And that is, yung wooing is the work of the Holy Spirit. We are speaking in Christian circle lamang, okay? And then, third, ating mapapansin ay sa prevenient grace, desire of God, okay, in pursuing them. Ang Panginoon ang siyang magpupursu sa kanila upang sila ay walang kawala, nakabahagi sa rapture tulad ng kanilang mga magulang. Okay? Hindi sila iwanan para sila ay makapagpatuloy sa kasalanan o kaya maging problema at makaranas ng matitinding pagdurusa sa rapture. Ultimately, they will die of famine because no one will take care of them. Ang hirap ng panahong yon kung maiwanan kayo. The fourth ay the gift of God will take charge that it will set them free. They will not be punished for their sin because, okay, or Adam's sin. Although they are conceived in sin, and yet the Lord has taken charge of that matter. And I will conclude this. And then fifth, the activity of God, ang gawain ng Panginoon, He will be the one who will empower that particular child to be a partaker and have participation sa rapture ng kanyang magulang. So dito, I summing it all up, ang prevenience grace ng Panginoon, extra special ito lalo na sa mga infants. Ito ay masusumpungan way back to the Old Testament until the New Testament. Before God judges yung Nineveh, nalilipulin niya talaga wholesale na mamamayan doon, ay for the sake of the infants that have not known good and evil, ay God spared Nineveh. Nakita ba ninyo yon? And as a matter of fact, the whole city, they turned to God for mercy. Nakita nyo yon? Second, si Samuel, si David, nung namatayan siya, ay ang kanyang first son kay Bathsheba, followed by another 4 sons, doon ang layan ng Panginoon, ay namatay ito in infancy. Grabing kapigatian at lungkot at naroon si David, nag-aayuno. But nung namatay ito, he was cheered up in spirit. At ang sabi niya, well, my child will not come back to me, but I will go to him. Alam niya nasa kami ng Panginoon. God cannot punish us for the sin of Adam. God will only justice demands that God will only punish sinners on the basis of their own sins, not because of the nature that Adam passed on to them. Nakita ba rin niya? That's why those of us that are of age, we can discern right from wrong. We are accountable for our sins because we are sinner by nature. Sila ay sinner by nature lang, mga sanggol. But we are a sinners by choice. Sinners by nature, okay, by choice. And we are sinners not only by this, by design, na talagang hinahanap ito ng likas nating makasalanan. Practice. We are sinners by nature, by choice, and by practice. That's why even though we may be saved, nagkakasala pa tayo. And who does not? And God had given a safety net for this, that if we confess our sins, He is just and righteous to forgive us. Hindi sinasabi ng Panginoon, mayroon, nagkasala ka, wala ka ng kaligtasan, dapat maligtas ka uli. How many times will you be born again? Several times ba? You are only born again once. Just like you are born again once in the flesh, you are only born once in the spirit. Okay, nakita na ba ninyo? Kaya at least it's a comfort to Christian parents. Now, should the rapture come during their pregnancy or infancy, mga anak, ay kasama natin yan. But it is, while we await the rapture, it is the Christian's business and parents' business to teach them of the Lord in their infancy. As a matter of fact, while still in the womb, the mother should listen to the gospel, and it affects the baby. Okay? Christian hymns. And last, but not the least, medyo tumatakbo na ako, because I do not want to leave any stone unturned pagdating sa rapture. Then last, the rapture is a motivation. It's a motivation. So chapter 15, verse, after having shown how victorious we are overcomers through Christ who loved us and gave himself for us, he gave the rapture as a motivation. He closes with this very inspiring verse in verse 58. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as you know that your labor, your service, your good works are not in vain in the Lord. Hindi walang saysay yung mga pagpapagal, paglilingkod at mga bagay nito ay sa Panginoon inihandog at ipinagkakaloob. During her lifetime sa England, isang kilalang mangangaral by the name of Dean Farrar, naging advisor ng Queen Victoria of England. Itong si Queen Victoria was a Christian queen. Mananampalataya siya. Pagkatapos siyang makarinig ng mensahe on the coming again of Jesus Christ, ay nagsalita siya kay Dean Farrar. Sabi niya, "Reverend, oh I wish the Lord Jesus Christ would come in my lifetime." Tagalog. O Dean, advisor niya, sana hangad ko ng Panginoon, inaasam-asam ko ng Panginoon ay dumating na ako'y buhay pa dito sa mundong ibabaw. Sobrang overworld, words na, verbos na. So anyway, that's Tagalog, mahaba talaga ang translation. Then, ito sabi ni Dean Farrar, a preacher, counselor, sabi niya, "Your Majesty, bakit naman angad mo?" Okay, sabi niya, "Kasi kung dumating ang Panginoon na ako'y buhay pa, ay isang karangalan ko at aking inaasam-asam rin na ang aking korona ay aking ilalagak sa kanyang paanan. That when the Lord comes in my lifetime, it will be an honor for me to take off my crown and kneel before the Lord and offer Him which He deserves, my crown." Nakikita, nakuha ba ninyo? Kung hindi, bahala kayo. Everything will be laid up. Kahit yung mga matatamasa nating mga crowns sa pagharap natin sa pagbibili. Lord, I least deserve this. You take it, Lord, and do as you please, when and how you please. But the Lord says, you earn it, and I am pleased to give it to you. You cannot take off that crown because it is not a crown rival. It's a lay, it's a garland as a winner. Robin, only those royalties na may crowns, yung diadema ay isusuko nila sa Panginoon. Pero kung angad ng Panginoon, ubarin ko, ilalagay ko sa kanya, you really deserve it, Lord. And as the Lord comes, motivation ito, sapagkat the rapture is a happy day. Di ba pag may reunion kayo, family reunion, whatever occasion, especially come New Year, family reunion, di ba masaya yon? Okay, nagkakatipon kayo. Eh, kung marami na sa family nyo na naroon na, ay reduce na yung reunion niyo. It's not as happier than when they were still around. Kaya the rapture will be a reunion day. Okay? You will be reunited. Okay? And then, it's going to be a day of rejoicing without ceasing. Sabi ng apostle, pray without ceasing. Rapture will determine that unceasing rejoicing. Because doon, no more tears, no more sorrows, no more partings, and no more sufferings, no more sickness, and we shall be with the Lord forever and ever and ever. This is a motivation for every child of God, living or dead. So dito'y ating mapapansin na ang ating Panginoong Jesucristo is coming again. Perhaps today, we do not know. Before this day closes, perhaps tonight, perhaps tomorrow, the imminence is any moment he may come and may he find us ready. Hindi tayo nagtutulog. Hindi ka man lang paalam sa akin. Dorothy, kukunin mo na pala ako. Nakapaganda man lang sana. No, sir, no, ma'am. Whether you are ready or not, if you are in Christ, you will meet him and see him face to face. Sabi ni John the Beloved, and we shall see him face to face, and we shall be like him. Happy day, happy day. And it is. May this comfort of the rapture strengthen us, encourage us to work out our salvation, because if you have sown much for the Lord, you will also reap much. You will be gainers and never losers. Father, bless your word. Thank you that finally, after several meetings, we ended up hopefully without leaving a stone unturned relative to the teaching of the Bible on such matter as the rapture of the saints. Thank you for your saving grace. Thank you for your prevenient grace. Thank you that you have not dealt with us after our sins, but you have dealt with our sins through our substitute, whom you sent, your own beloved Son, the sinless one dying for the guilty sinners like us. And we may not be able to pay for it, but we can certainly thank you for reaching down to us and saving us by your grace and for your glory. Bless all those that are with us here, and as well as those that are in the respective homes. following us in our worship time online. Thank you for the freedom that we could meet and worship you in spite of the dreaded plague that has been here for a year now. Only God knows when it will stop. But somehow you have taught us meanings that life in Christ is worth living and is coming again. We anticipate with much gusto, with much hope. In Jesus' name I pray. If someone in our midst who is not wholly and fully saved and merely a church member, I pray that you would extend him that or her that saving grace. If he or she is truly saved and is not a member of this thy church, they may be members of parachurch organizations, extra biblical groups that do not have the history, the doctrines, and the practice as you have given us as a legacy. I do pray that they would submit to the full authority of heaven, where they can glorify the Lord best. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's sing a song. One stanza or two stanzas will do. Okay, expressing that blessed hope that we have. Even so, come, Lord Jesus. Okay, let's sing a song, Brother Sunny. What would the Lord have you to do this morning, whether you are on site or online? What is God's will for your life to happen and for you to submit this morning?
Well, let's all stand and let's stand our hymnal to hymn number 107. Christ we turn it. Let's sing the first and the last time support.
It may be at morn, when the day is awaking, when sunlight through darkness and shadow is breaking, that Jesus will come in the fullness of glory to receive from the world his own. Oh Lord Jesus, how long have we shut that glad song? Christ returneth, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, amen. Last now. Oh joy, oh delight, should we go without dying? No sickness, no sadness, no dread and no crying. Go up to the clouds with the Lord into Jesus receives his own. Oh Lord Jesus, how long have we shout that glad song? Christ returned, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen.
afternoon service, which starts at 4:30, and we have just begun on the book of Ezekiel, perhaps one, if not the most difficult book in the Bible. And then, so Wednesday, we are starting a series of messages on the greatest person that ever lived on earth. Who do you think is it? Our Lord Jesus Christ. Okay, so may God bless us with spiritual growth and in grace that we would certainly appreciate Him, adore Him, and we would be humble and thankful that He crossed our paths this side of heaven and assuring us of the very best in the afterlife and eternity. And the people of God said,
Amen. Amen.
God bless you all and have a wonderful noon and day during this Lord's Day.